The SolarC 15K is a powerful, highly praised inverter from a well-established company. It does come with a premium price tag, but is the performance worth the price, or are you better off saving your hard-earned money for something else? Welcome back to the lab, where our opinions can't be bought. Despite SolarC's popularity, this is actually our first time with a SolarC product here in the lab. We've been putting this guy through the ringer for the past couple weeks, and we didn't go easy on this guy because they claim it exceeds 2 times military grade standards to keep working against both lightning strikes and military grade weapons attacks. Now, we don't have any military grade weapons, but we wanted to see how hard we could push this guy and get it as close to blowing up as we possibly could. As always, if you get tired of listening to us and you want to take a look at the SolarC 15K, pop down to the link down below. Any coupon codes we can get out of SolarC, information on this month's giveaway, and subscribe if you haven't already. Now let's get you up to speed on the SolarC 15K. First up, this guy passes the tiny baby lift test at 135 pounds, not far off a tiny baby's weight. It's a 48 volt split phase inverter, which means it'll put out 120 volts and 240 volts. It's also a hybrid inverter, which means that it's capable of running on-grid, off-grid, and selling power back to the grid. It's got a 19.5 kilowatt solar input, 200 amp AC pass-through, and a continuous output of 15 kilowatts. When we tested this guy, its idle consumption was about 97 watts. Now, taking a look at its build, it's all pretty good. It's got a nice screen. It looks a little like Windows 95. It's touch and button control, which is pretty nice. On the side here, we've got your latches for the good sturdy door. You have to add your own lock on these guys. They aren't locking latches. We've got the handles that kind of pinch your hands if you're trying to lift these guys. Not ideal, but they are good and sturdy.
Ow! F*** you! Ow!
On the far side, we've got your PV breaker, your power switch, and your Wi-Fi dongle, which is actually placed much nicer than the unit we were just working with by SunGold, which kind of hangs off the bottom, not as ideal. And looking behind the panel, everything's laid out pretty well on this guy. You've got your battery connections and breaker on the far side. You've got your solar connections in the center, along with your generator terminal connections, your load, and your grid. Funny thing about this guy is there's not actually a grid breaker, but we'll get into that later on. This guy is NEMA 4X weather rated, so it can be used outside. It does also have an app, which wasn't a very good app, but we'll get into that. Otherwise, everything's really well labeled. It's easy to use. It was a great starting setup on this unit. And right now you can get this guy for $6,699. But at Shop Solar with our discount code, you can get it for $6,431, which is kind of expensive, but the quality might be worth it. Right off the top, the things that we like about this guy, performance. Now, when you're buying an inverter, that's probably the most important thing, and this guy nailed it. We were able to cruise it right at its capacity as long as it wanted to run, and we had no issues at all. We were actually able to start our compressor when this guy was cruising at its 15,000 watt load twice. And that compressor has a surge rating of about 10,000 watts. So to be able to run at 15,000, start the compressor, shut it off, and start the compressor again, in our books, is insane performance. Probably the most important point to nail home with an inverter. So basically what that means is you'll have no problem starting your air conditioner or a bigger appliance, regardless of the load that you're running on this inverter, it's gonna perform for you. Next thing we really liked about this guy was the screen. It actually has some different colors going on, so it makes it a little more interesting. It is touch and button controlled, so you're not totally limited in how you're able to control the unit, which is nice, especially because the app isn't very helpful. So good job on the screen on the front. Some units are lacking pretty heavily there. We also really like that this unit has a clear protective cover on the inside. It's nice because it kind of lets you troubleshoot anything that might be going wrong on the inside of the panel without actually having to remove the protective panel altogether. You can leave it screwed on, make sure things are in the right place while having the inverter functioning with a little less risk of being shocked. While we're on the inside, the terminal connections are all really good. They're all pretty sturdy blocked terminal connections. They're not plastic with tiny little set screws. The battery terminals are really nice bolt-on style, so you know that once those lines are connected, they're really not going anywhere. You might think that should be standard, but we've seen some inverters where the terminal connections are so flaky, you feel like once you put the wire in, you'll rip apart half the inverter if you were even giving them a tug. So it's nice to know that they're not going anywhere. Last up, we really liked the support that we got from Solark. When we called, they actually answered their phones.
Solark support, how may I help you?
Hi there, how are you doing today? It was clearly an American support team. We did have to walk them through a little bit of the problem, even though we already knew the solution, but at the end of the day, they helped us figure it out. And when you answer the phone, it's better than, yeah, leave us a message, we'll send you an email, or ship us off to another country to try and walk us through something that they know nothing about. First thing we don't like about this guy is the high frequency noise that comes out of it, especially when you're running it at a higher load. The cool thing is that when you're running it at a high load, the fans are actually really quiet. So the only noise you do really hear is that slight frequency. Now the app was really difficult to get connected to the unit. You can see in the screenshot that we got for you, it wasn't even recognizing the QR codes on both the side of the panel and the inside of the door. The interface of the app isn't the greatest, especially when you compare it to some of the power station apps. They're like really nice user interface. This one kind of looks like a back-end system. And lastly, there's also no grid breaker in this guy. Now, if you're really wanting to service either your inverter or anything downline of your inverter, it's nice to know that you can safely shut off the grid power. So the fact that there's no breaker in this guy is like a little bit sketchy. Overall, we really did love this unit here in the lab. If you can put up with a little bit of the high frequency noise and don't mind that there's no grid breaker, then this guy's gonna continue to perform for you. We really did give it a hard time, and overall, we can see why Solark is such a well-known brand. They put out a really good product. For now, that's all we have for you today. If you're interested in this guy, check out the link down below. Also, while you're there, information on this month's giveaway, subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out and stay charged.